Hi, I'm Valerie Steele. I'm delighted to be talking to you today about Isabel Toledo. I first met Isabel in 1989 when I was working on my book, Women of Fashion. And Isabel said to me, "I never thought of myself as a designer. I'm a seamstress. I really love the technique of sewing more than anything else." When I pointed out that some people might think that being a designer was more prestigious, she interrupted me urgently, saying, "But the seamstress is the one who knows fashion from the inside. That's the art form, really, not fashion design, but the technique of how it's done." Because of her brilliant technique and strong personal vision, Isabel Toledo was able to create original and significant forms. Isabel always worked in close collaboration with her husband, the artist Ruben Toledo. They were both born in Cuba, came to the U.S. as small children, and they met in high school in New Jersey. Isabel told me, "Ruben is a visual person. She never sketched, but she sewed since she was a child. And as an adult, her thought process was unique. She saw her clothes in three dimensions in her mind's eye. Then she'd describe her idea or feeling to Ruben, and he'd sketch it." The museum at FIT organized two exhibitions. One, Ruben and Isabel Toledo, The Marriage of Art and Fashion, 1998. And two, Isabel Toledo, Fashion from the Inside Out, in 2009. The exhibitions both arranged clothes according to certain categories that were important to Isabel. Isabel's hermaphrodite evening dress is one of her suspension dresses. That is, it's a result of her experimentation with tension and the effects of gravity on cloth. It's made of silk taffeta, and the fabric pouches are gathered and then suspended, creating amorphous forms that transform the shape of the female figure. Other categories included shadows, involving lace and underpinnings, origami, and shapes. Shapes was about strong silhouettes, especially as exemplified by her work in denim. In the exhibitions, we included many patterns and diagrams to show how Isabel transformed two-dimensional patterns into three-dimensional garments. For many years, Isabel was known as a designer's designer. That is, fashion insiders were obsessed with her brilliance, and she had a definite influence on other designers. The reviews, however, were mixed. Women's Wear Daily once described her collection as an artsy horror show. Eccentricity was permitted and encouraged in London and Paris, but in New York, designers were supposed to be commercial. After 1998, Isabel stopped mounting shows because of the expense, but she still had important retailers like Barney's in New York and Ikram in Chicago. Isabel only really became famous after Michelle Obama wore her lemongrass dress and coat to President Obama's first inauguration. She was part of fashion history from the beginning of her career, but it was the work she did for Mrs. Obama that brought her into history. In 2008, Isabel Toledo received the Couture Council Award for Artistry of Fashion from the museum at FIT, one of several such prizes acknowledging her brilliance. Her patterns, use of materials, and methods of draping are all highly experimental, yet her clothes are practical. If you want to learn more about Isabel Toledo or other designers, please look at our online collections.